Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Inez Olea, and today it's another Tip Trick Tuesday. In today's Tip Trick Tuesday, I will show you how to improve your After Effects performance, make it render faster, and just improve your general productivity. We all know the story of After Effects crashing or just freezing, or it's just way too slow to make something. Sometimes I have these moments that I'm so motivated to create something and I wanna jump into After Effects and start creating, and then everything is so slow and I just get demotivated within the minute because I just can't produce what I'm having in my mind, and my mind is going so fast, but After Effects is just not willing to allow me to produce something. And then on other days when I'm not that motivated, After Effects is just working fine. So that's something we have to live with. But in this video, I will show you a few tips and tricks to optimize After Effects. All right, so the first tip is actually a very simple one, but one of the most important ones actually. Imagine you're working on a 4K resolution composition. It's not really ideal, especially because you're working and your preview is actually rather small. So if you're gonna lower your resolution while working, you're not really going to notice any difference. So even if you're going in fine detail, you could actually lower the resolution of your preview. You can simply do that by going over here and going to full and change the resolution over here. So you can go for auto, which will automatically choose a resolution good for your composition. You can also go for half, or third, or quarter. I wouldn't recommend going over third because quarter is really, really bad in resolution quality. So if we're going to take a look here, we can barely see any detail in here. But if you go to third, because I'm working with a 4K resolution comp, you're not going to notice much difference between the third and the full resolution, or even half in this case would be a little bit better instead of full. But yeah, just keep in mind that these effects will look a little bit different in these resolutions. So if you want to see the actual final result, go in full resolution. And then when you're continuing on working on your project, just lower that resolution. All right, so the next tip actually is also in the preview monitor. You also have another option to change the preview's quality and to make it a lot faster. So in here, you have this little button over here, which is currently set to off and means final quality. And if you're going to move through the composition, you will see that this is the final quality. I'm gonna set this to full so you can see the actual result. And if you're going to change this to adaptive resolution, for example, you're not going to notice much difference, but it's going to load a little bit faster if we click through all our effects. So this is a good way to actually work on your composition. And once your composition gets very complex, it's actually going to adaptively remove the resolution a little bit. You can also go for fast draft, which is extremely fast. But here you have to note that like blending modes and stuff like that is not going to be noted. So you can see that now if we're going to click how fast that loads, click, click, and you can see that instantly loads up everything. And if I change this back to off, you'll see how much time it needs to render. So I click now, we wait a second and a half or something. And with the fast draft, it's a lot faster. So in some occasions, you could use that to quickly scroll through your composition, see what's going on and stuff like that. The next tip I have for you guys is close all the panels. It's very essential to close all the panels that you don't use because they also use CPU to perform and to open up and to have some cache behind them. So definitely go in After Effects, check what you're using, what you're not using. For example, the tracker, I'm using it for now. Align, I use it a lot. Paint, I barely use it, so I'm going to close it up. Let's see here, we have the transition shifter, which I can also close, and some other stuff. So we can see these are things I rather use, except this one. And then we can go over here for the info panel. I don't need that. Preview, maybe, but actually I just use my hotkeys on the computer, on my keyboard. I don't need this. Neither do I need this or this. So now I closed all these panels, maybe close down all the compositions I'm not using for now. And then over here we can see that we have everything. Okay, so this is just a basic one. All right, so I know this is kind of basic, but it really helps to make After Effects perform a little bit faster, especially when you're using laptops or any kind of that. Especially in Premiere Pro, this is very handy. After Effects doesn't have all these panels, but when you're starting out on Premiere, you will see that you have a ton of panels that you're barely using, so close them. All right, so imagine you have a few layers, like in my composition right now, now and you're applying a bunch of effects to each individual layer, but the effects are exactly the same. That's not really the best way on going about this, because now it has to calculate it for each different layer. So that means five times it has to calculate the same information. So in that case, what do you do? We can see right here that we have this composition. I'm actually going to set this to off, final quality. We can see that if we're going to effects, we have a solid composite, a Gaussian blur, and a perfect glow, which is a preset of ours, applied to this layer. And we have this applied to every single layer over here. So what I'll do is go to this layer and select all the effects, Control X to cut them. Then I'll go over here and again, delete it over here, delete it over here, and all of these. So one more. There we go. So now what I will do is select all these layers, including their tracking information, and I'll go to layer, pre-compose this, move all the attributes in that new composition, and just rename it to like footsteps. And now we have a pre-comp. So what you could do is now basically go into that composition and create an adjustment layer, or just apply the effect to the composition itself. But if you want to later kind of make this a little bit more complex, you have all the effects in here. So I'm going to call this effects and just paste these effects with Control V. Now we have applied them, and actually with the solid composite, it solid composites everything. So that's pretty great. And if we're going back to that same composition and set the blending mode to a screen, we'll see that nothing has changed. It's actually all the same. So that's really cool. And it's a lot faster now because it's only calculating these effects once. Another thing you can do is actually render out your pre-comped compositions with a bunch of effects applied to them, so you can render them faster later on, and also while you're working on your project. In order to do that, just solo the composition you're using and go for a render. Okay, so in this case, I wouldn't go for the final render settings, which is for me mostly H.264, which is great for online video, but this format does have a quality loss in general. So if you're going to do this a bunch of times and you render out things multiple times, the quality is gonna get worse over time. So in this case, I will go for an image quality, either it's PNG or TIFF. So I'm going for a PNG sequence, and I'm going to click on PNG sequence right over here. You can also render it out with an alpha if you want to. In this case, it's not necessary, so I'm going to toggle that off because it's going to keep, well, it's going to give me less information to render out. So export as a sequence, go for the location, open up that folder and rename it to footsteps actually sequence, and save that out and just click OK and export these right over here. So now you have your image sequence rendered out, and go into After Effects to import it again. So what I will do is go to my project manager and go right click import file, which I suppose is clear for you guys. Then go to that folder and click on the first layer. Make sure that you have PNG sequence checked on and import that PNG sequence. So now we have an image sequence that is going to be imported in Adobe After Effects right here. Now, very importantly, before you actually switch up these two compositions, well, this composition for this footage, go to your composition and go to composition settings. Here we'll see that you have a frame rate of 24 FPS. Very importantly is to right click on your image sequence, go to interpret footage, main, and change this back to assume this frame rate 24. Click OK. Otherwise, the length is not going to be exactly the same. Click on your footsteps, go Alt and hold Alt and click on your layer, and then just drag it over. That will replace this with your image sequence. And now if we're going to unsolo this, look how freaking fast this renders. Oh my God, love it. You thought everything had to be difficult in order to optimize your rendering, but actually a lot of people just render out everything as a PNG sequence or TIFF sequence and then just re-import it to continue on their more complex scenes. Now let's dive into the settings a little deeper to see if we can solve anything a little bit more. So if we go in After Effects and go to Edit, Preferences, here we can go to Previews, and we can choose the adaptive resolution limit right here, maybe even lower. And you can also change the zoom quality and the color management quality to be faster. But in my opinion, the default settings are really necessary for my projects. But you can play around with these, try to see what it does and how it works. Then next you can go to media and disk cache. So here you can choose a folder for your disk cache. I would suggest that you go for a folder that is SSD. So currently it's set to my C drive, which is not SSD. Go to your computer, SSD, create a new folder and maybe rename this to cache. Open up that folder, create a new folder and rename it to After Effects. There we go, and click select this folder. So now our cache files are going to be sent to an SSD drive, which is going to read and write your cache files a lot faster, and that's actually very nice. We can also maximum this cache size, set this to maybe like 30, or just increase it as much as you can. And you can also empty the disk cache once in a while to just make sure that you don't have a full set folder for this. So here we go, we have cleaned our cache. Then you can also clean the database and cache. And now let's say After Effects crashes a lot or you have a lot of problems with your computer. Also another tip that doesn't necessarily improve the performance of After Effects, but it improves your projects in general. Because if After Effects crashes and you didn't save it for a long time, you lose everything. So you can also go in here to the auto save settings and actually save it every 10 minutes, for example. Because in 10 minutes, I actually do a lot. And if I would lose 20 minutes of work, I would be very frustrated. So you will see an autosave often, well, more often, but I actually want to trade that in for a safer project. And then go into memory. So in memory, you have the installed RAM. So I have 32 gigabytes of RAM. And now you can also select the RAM reserved for other applications while you're using After Effects. So I would make this as low as possible because in order, well, the more RAM you give to After Effects, the better it will perform, which is kind of logical. After that, just click OK and we're done with these settings. The next step is just to simply solo your layers that you're working on. So if you're working on a complex project like this one and you're working on this specific foot, you can just go in here and solo these two or just solo this foot and focus on it. If you want to see something more, just solo that one as well right over here, and then you can kind of compare these two, but just don't work on all of them all at the same time. And soloing is the easiest way of knowing which layers you need and which you don't, so you can just unsolo these and then you see the entire composition again. You can also uncheck your adjustment layers again while you're working. And now for our last tip, just don't work with effects that are intensive for your processor. And if you don't know these, you will actually notice it while you're working on them, like glows are very slow, blurs are very slow, especially motion blur. So for example, if you have set up motion blur by toggling the switches, setting all the motion blur to on, and you also have motion blur checked on for the composition. In this case, I don't really have anything that actually needs motion blur. But anyway, if you would have that, just uncheck motion blur for now. If you have a perfect glow applied, just try it first, look how that looks on your footage, and then just disable it for now and then just wait until you're done with the entire project to come back to this and just enable it again. Because these things are essentially what makes After Effects slower while you're working on a project. And yes, it is kind of a trade-off that you don't see your entire project completely done already, but just it makes it a lot better. And now for a last bonus tip, just save more money for a better computer. All right, I know this was kind of rude of me because a lot of people are just doing this as a hobby or trying to learn or are just too young and don't have the budget to invest in a better computer. But I would advise you, if you're looking into a computer for better performance, After Effects on a budget, I would recommend you to go obviously to a Windows computer because it's a lot cheaper than Mac computers. And it also is easier to kind of improve your computer later on. I would also advise you to make your own computer or let someone that knows how to do it build it, but it's going to be a lot cheaper for one and you have 100% control on what you put in your computer. I would also advise you to work with an NVIDIA graphics card because that supports CUDA. And the CUDA performance in video editing software software is amazing. So I would really advise you to take a look for that. If you're looking into some kind of laptop, but you see yourself often at home, then I would also invest in a desktop computer, because these are, again, lower budget, have a better airflow, and it's just generally better for heavier projects. And yes, this is all my personal opinion, but I just want to give you some tips when you're looking into buying a computer. If you want to see what computer I'm using, I will put a card on this video right here, so you can go and check it out. All right, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to this channel. Also, hit the notification bell so you get notified when I upload new videos. Also, check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers, motion graphics artists, and even photographers. So everything for the online creative. And if you buy something from our website, that would be amazing to support this channel and create better content. So apart from that, I hope to see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.